I understand it wasn't a scheduled annual visit. Can you tell us what it was?
Yeah, absolutely. We've got a really busy year ahead, as you can imagine. And so the president decided to go to Walter Reed and kind of get a head start with some routine checkups as part of his annual exam. That's all it was. It was very routine. We had a down day today, and so he made the decision to head there.
And there's no truth to the rumors that it was something else, because the rumors are flying.
Oh, the rumors are always flying. Absolutely not. He is healthy as can be. I put a statement out about that. He's got more energy than anybody in the White House. That man works from 6 a.m. until, you know, very, very late at night. He's doing just fine.
You know, Stephanie, he's almost superhuman. I don't know how anyone can deal with what he's dealing with. It's just, I mean, I get frustrated with what's going on in Washington. I mean, I want to throw things at the television, but I don't.
You know, who was it? Was it Mnuchin who praised his perfect genes? Was it Steve Mnuchin that said he had superhuman genes?
Yeah, I think it was.
And then Dr. Ronnie said he would live to be 200 if he ate a little bit better.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, the quack doctor that gave the analysis of how he was this superhuman.
Yes.
And we found out the doctor was a super fraud.
Super fraud, and this all continues, and they're talking about he works so hard. No, he's got like one event. I think he does one or two things a day. Tops. All right, Jonathan Mimir, break this down. I mean, by the way, he's picked up, magically picked up. He's 2 inches taller now than he was a couple of years ago, right?
Congratulations.
The bone spurs are growing and pushing him up. And also the weight, I'm sorry. I know a guy that weighs about 240, 241. This guy is pushing 300. There is no doubt about it. No, there's no doubt. There's no doubt about it. Maybe he's 270. Maybe he's 280.
Not that there's anything wrong with that.
I'm not saying there is. I'm just saying we have a right to know our president's health. And he's done nothing but lie to us about it for several years. Ronnie Jackson was the most laughable. But tell us, we don't know what happened. What do you know?
We don't. But certainly the White House has credibility issues. So let's start there.
I've never seen the press secretary before.
Right, on the president's health, but also other matters. So what happened Saturday was strange. His previous two physical exams were announced well in advance. They were put on his public schedule the day before. The press pool that travels with the president knew where they were going, to Walter Reed and so on. What happened Saturday was not. There was a motorcade movement with the press pool. They were not told where they were going. They were not allowed to report it until they arrived at Walter Reed, which they did that afternoon.
Ooh.
This was not advised in advance. This was deemed a partial physical, which is something that usually physicals are not divided in parts, at least not that I'm aware of. I'm not a doctor like others who have been on the show, but that's not my sense of it. This is also something, his last physical was in February, so we're nowhere near the year mark for this next one to happen again. And as a final note, you know, while he was spotted walking into the motorcade on Saturday on the way to Walter Reed, he had no public events yesterday. He was not spotted. According to his schedule today, he has a couple of closed events, so reporters won't see him again. So it'll be now a third straight day where no one will have seen him in the aftermath of whatever happened on Saturday.
I mean, he's getting today, I think, an intel briefing.
He's got a meeting. Yeah, right. He's meeting with an intel briefing and then the Secretary of State. But he's not supposed to have any events that are open to the press.
Right.
All right. In her recent column for The Washington Post entitled, "We Need a Second Opinion on the President's Health," Karen Tumulty writes in part this: "The only thing of which we can be fairly certain about President Trump's mysterious Saturday afternoon trip to Walter Reed National Military Medical Center is this. The White House is not telling truth when it claims the president was there to begin portions of his routine annual physical exam. We know this because those people lie about pretty much everything. Medical privacy is something that should not be granted the most powerful person in the world. As Trump embarks on his effort to convince us that he deserves another 4 years in office, Americans should demand something more than what they are getting, starting with a briefing from the physicians who treated him at Walter Reed."
Well, that's not going to happen. Let's bring in right now Morning Joe medical contributor Dr. Dave, political writer for The New York Times and MSNBC political analyst Nick Confessori, and national correspondent for The Washington Post, Philip Bump, joins us as well. So, Dr. Dave, so even if you believe these skewed numbers, that Donald Trump magically grew 2 inches higher over the past several years, and that he only weighs 243, which is about 40 pounds short. But even if you believe those lies, he's still obese. So wouldn't his obesity or possibly his morbid obesity, if we actually get updated numbers that show that, that has to be a huge health risk for him, especially at his advanced age.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Joe, there's actually a much bigger health risk that's not been well reported. It turns out that last year he had a coronary artery scale done with a CT scan that showed that he had increased about 400% from 2009 to 2018. The coronary calcium scale is an indication of risk for heart attack and stroke. He's now in moderate risk. That's been well stated. It seems like last year, early February 2019, the CT scan for his heart may have been done before the physical exam. That being said, as a doctor, I will tell you, I like to have tests done before I see the patient if I know they're needed. So if, in fact, a very plausible explanation is he went in for a coronary artery calcium CT scan and is now awaiting that result. He's under active treatment for coronary artery disease. He is increasing his statin level. He just needs to tighten up his diet, lower his weight, as you said. But I think we will likely find out that this was indeed the beginning of a physical exam that will end in February. It's my belief.
So you say his health risks are that he's too heavy. He gets too little exercise. You also talk about his processed food diet. It seems like, again, at least health-wise, the president is making things much more difficult on himself health-wise.
According to the American Heart Association, he is at a moderate risk right now for heart attack or stroke. That's up from just a few years ago when he was at a mild risk. Increasing weight, increasing cholesterol that he's trying to lower with Crestor, which is a statin, is a way to combat the reality that his heart risk is increasing.
Now, you say this could have been an early, this could be phase one of a two-phase physical. Would you really begin that about 6 months after you just had your last physical?
Yeah, because, Joe, he's under active treatment for heart disease risk, heart attack and stroke. They've increased his Crestor, which is a statin. Right. They're trying to lower it, which is a way to lower his risk of having a heart attack or a stroke.
If you're under that regimen, and this is a concern of doctors, and obviously, if you have any like chest tightening, pain in the arms, anything like that, you need to get to the hospital immediately, right?
You do, absolutely.
Yeah. All right, Dr. Dave, thank you so much. Greatly appreciate it.
You're welcome.
Anybody want to talk about the president's health before we go to Louisiana? John Meacham, let's just say up front here that while this president seems to lie about everything, the one thing that presidents have always lied about is their health.
That's exactly the point. I mean, even Franklin Roosevelt, Woodrow Wilson, the people obfuscated about Dwight Eisenhower's heart attack. President Kennedy was the subject in a medical journal for someone who suffered from Addison's disease, and they lied about it all the way through. So even great presidents have obfuscated and outright lied about their health because they didn't want to deal with the political costs of admitting vulnerability.
And Taft physicians claimed he came in at 198 pounds, I'm sure, as well, just like Trump.
Oh, well, you know, he was doing a lot of medicine ball endorsements back in the day. So if Franklin Roosevelt and John Kennedy did it, you know, I think our worry should go to warp speed here.
Yeah. Hey, Adrian, I was having a conversation with Alex while John Meacham was finishing his speech. Everybody looked at me, and I'm like, going, why are they staring at me? Meacham's talking. Then I find out.